I'll start with sourcing and procurement. So we'll start with sourcing and procurement. In simple logistics. Procurement is a strategic function. It plays a very important role in the cost structure and it provides a competitiveness of small and a very large business. Core in the line of business solutions in the SAP S/4HANA is available under sourcing and procurement. Sourcing and procurement is a process of obtaining and managing different raw materials, primarily needed for the manufacturing of the product or providing a service. Sourcing and procurement is nothing but purchase to pay. Or procure to pay. But we call it as P2P. In SAP S/4HANA, it supports three kinds of procure to pay processes. We can view the visibility or insights that is mainly used to realize the purchase of the product and to enforce strategic vendor prices. It provides users to configure and also to consumer gate for user experience. We also mainly use it for different kinds of efficiency. We can also generate real-time analytics and to manage purchases with regards to greater efficiency and productivity. I hope all the participants are able to hear me because I just got a message participants not able to hear me. I hope all the participants are able to hear me. And thank you. Thank you so much. Okay. Now, so what are the major simplifications that are available in the areas of inventory management, also available in the material requirement, material requirements planning, also in the capacity planning. And also available at sales and distribution. So we'll discuss about different simplification lists in the S4HANA. So it provides the major simplification in these areas. Now let us focus on changes that are made in the S4HANA. So, with the introduction of SAP S4HANA, inside the sourcing and procurement, by compiling an SAP Fiori user experience is introduced to convert all the purchase requisitions into purchase orders. Mainly the changes are made to SAP Fiori and different business network integration. Self-service, self-service requisitioning, supplier and category management. So the SAP Fiori that is introduced here is mainly based on operational purchasing, buyer, on the manager front also, and the employee. Accounts and payable accountant. The complete requesting process that is supported in SAP Fiori, from creating the purchase order and also creation of requisitions and to confirmation of goods and services. In SAP S4HANA, the data is accessed in real time by reading data directly from purchasing tables. So you have different purchasing tables such as EKB, EKKO, EKPO, and we also visualizing the content directly in SAP Fiori Launchpad. Business network integration. Now, in SAP S4HANA, on the integration scenarios, self-service requisitioning allows to create and to manage back to the order efficiency and it is a new capability in SAP S4HANA which does not exist in supplier and category management into managing purchasing categories and to manage suppliers and to evaluate suppliers mainly when doing real-time analytics. So these are the main changes that are available after migrating to sourcing and procurement. In sourcing and procurement, we have four end-to-end solution capabilities. So we have four end-to-end solution capabilities. The first one is operational procurement. The second one, invoice and payables management. Sourcing and contract management. Supply information and master data. So these are the four end-to-end capabilities that are available in sourcing and procurement. Okay, participants. So in operational procurement, self-service requisitioning, so different requirement processing purchase order processing service purchasing. Purchase order collaboration. And finally, procurement analytics. With SAP S/4HANA, the operational purchases across all the buying activities such as processing purchase requisitions to find an appropriate source of supply, creating and processing purchase orders. Invoice and payable management includes invoice processing, account payables, and invoice collaboration. Sourcing and contract management. Include source assignments, and operational contract management. So in the supplier information master data, so we have classification and segmentation, and also we have supplier evaluation. So today my main focus is on operational procurement. We'll discuss about operational procurement. So operational procurement includes self-service requisition, requirement processing, purchase order processing, service purchasing, purchase order collaboration, and procurement analytics. So self-service requisitioning is a new capability in the S/4HANA. Which is not available in SAP ERP. It was decided not to co-deploy SRM in the S/4HANA because it has a very technical clashes with the traditional CRM system. The traditional capabilities were developed directly on top of existing purchase requisition directly based on purchase requisition objects. With the introduction of SAP S/4HANA, the employee has to conduct self-service requisitioning the Fury apps that are introduced for self-service requisitioning. You have different Fury apps called as create, purchase, requisition, my purchase requisition, and confirm. Confirm receipt of goods. Once your purchase requisition has been approved, a purchase order is created. With self-service requisitioning, the purchase process is simplified for casual users and employees. With these capabilities, now we are going to discuss about self-service requisitioning. With the capability An employee can purchase goods and services directly, while he can ensure by following purchasing policies and also pricing agreements. So, participants, is the pace of delivery okay, or am I being a little slow? Or can I continue with this pace of delivery? Okay, so I think everyone feels okay. Thank you, participants. So, purchasing policies and pricing agreements, and also Fury apps that are available for create purchase requisition, my purchase requisitions, and confirm the receipt of goods. So coming to the requirement processing. So requirement processing is a unique value of SAP S/4HANA. Usually in SAP R/3, purchase requisitions are transformed into a purchase order, pricing the transactions ME 57. Here we are going to create purchase requisitions and convert purchase requisitions into purchase orders. Now, let us create purchase requisition. Let us log on to SAP logon. Double click on S4 IDS. Enter the user ID is best. Enter the password WCAPITAL_WELCOME123 and select continue with this logon. By using the key code ME51. So let us create purchase requisition with the T code ME51N. So in this session, we're going to see quickly we'll create a purchase requisition as an introduction in the SAP Fury Launchpad. So let us open SAP Fury apps. Let us open the Fury Launchpad. Let us copy the Fury link. So let us, after copying, let us go to Google Chrome. So let us open SAP Fury apps. Enter the user ID and password WCAPITAL_WELCOME123 and click log on. Now let us click on search icon. Enter the app to create. Create purchase requisition. Click enter. Let us double click on purchase requisition app. Now we can see the screen. As you had seen in the SAP GUI, enter the material. Before going to create purchase requisition, now let us first create the material. Let us go back. Let us go to create material app. So here we can see the create material. The material master contains confirmation on all the materials. That a company procures or produces the source or sell. And all the data it contains required to manage materials. It is the company central source for retrieving material specific data. Which information is stored in individual material master records. In ERP business suite, material master number it is in SAP ERP. In SAP S/4HANA it has been increased to 40 characters. By using OMSL transaction code on the ECC system. So let us log on to ECC. Let us enter OMSL transaction code and click enter. So you can see material number length 80. On the S/4HANA, you can check the activation of the extended material functionality. FLE TS transaction code. Or we can check in the IMD screen. Now let us see the middle functionality. Enter SPRO. Click on SAP Reference IMG. Expand cross application components. Here, general application functions. In here, we have field length extension, activate extended fields. Click on details. So here we can see extended material number in S4 HANA. So let us check this in ECC system. So we can enter either the transaction code, click on SAP Reference IMG, expand cross application components, expand general application functions. So here we don't see the options field length extensions, which we have seen in the SAP S4 HANA. It's a new feature introduced in SAP S4 HANA. We can check material length by using the transaction code OMSF. By going to the middle length, we are doing the middle length. It is extended to 40 in the SAP S4 HANA. As we primarily see in ECC, the material length is 18. Now, if it is changed to 19, it is not going to take. If you try to change the length, it is showing you the length is exceeded. Now let us go back to S4 HANA. Before going to create the material master, let me discuss about material types. Whenever you're creating a material, we need to create material type. Without material type, we cannot create materials. There are some standard material types, such as raw materials, and tracking materials, semi-finished product, finished material, and finished material. There are some standard material types like raw materials or semi-finished materials. The materials is procured and consumed in production. And no sales is nothing but raw materials which is procured and mainly used for packing and no sales. Is said to be packing materials, semi-finished materials are nothing but the materials which is no procurement and produced with no sales. Are said to be no procurement and produced so these are the different standard material types in SAP S/4HANA. Raw materials, packing materials, semi-finished materials. So here you can see the material type. These are some of the standard material. So these are some of the standard material types. Then we can customize based on the requirement. So Metal Master is based on three organization levels. That is data that is valid for the whole company. And data that is valid within one plant. And data valid for one storage location. So these are the three So these are the three changes that are mentioned in the S/4HANA system. So let us enter industry sector. Select as retail. Select as material types. And enter the select explore organization levels. So in here you can see different use in Metal Master like basic data, MRP, purchasing, sales organization, advanced planning, and like this we have different views in Metal Master based on the business views. we have to select fusion material. Select the use. Select sales organization. Select MRP. Select general plan data. Select accounting. Based on the business suit, we have to select the usage of materials. So enter the storage location. Select. Select 1010. So here you can see the storage location 1018. Now provide the description, material, so here you can see the metal number, which is provided by the system automatically. Now select base unit of measure. Select the base unit of measure, SEA. Then select the metal groups. Select the metal groups 01. So here metal group is a key that I have used to group together several materials or services with the same attribute. And unit of measure in which the stocks or the materials are managed. This system can convert all quantities that are entered in other units in the base unit of measure. Now, so here we can see, the MRP procedure or the MRP type. Select. The forecast transaction that controls the MRP procedures to be used for planning. Here we are only entering the mandatory fields. If you want, we can enter all the fields based on our requirement. So select lot sizing procedures. So based on our requirement, we can enter these fields. Now let us click on save. So we need to enter the availability to check. Select, enter the availability check and click enter. So then it will take you to all the mandatory fields. Select the order unit. select threads queue input. Click continue. Now we are in MRP2. Click enter. Here we can see the availability check. It helps you to make commitment to the customer. We will be able to deliver the customer on the desired timeline. And enter again. And click enter the valuation and select raw materials. So provide the evaluation class raw materials. Once we enter all the required fields, enter item category group. Select standard item and click enter and click on save. Now enter tax classification, enter 0, click on save. So here we can see material is created. Once we create the material, if you want to make any changes to the created material, include the sales metal arts. Double click on materials. Enter the metal number. Select the storage location and click continue. Let's change the material group. And once you make any change, click on save. So here you can see material is changed. If you want to see the changes, and click on mode, let's click mode. Let's select the storage location and click continue. To see the changes, click on environment and click on display changes. So here it will show all the change number the books with August. And just now we have changed metal group to 01202. Like this, if you make any changes to materials, we can observe the changes over here. Once you create the material, purchase, go back to the purchase requisition screen. Enter the quantity 10. Enter the quantity 1010. And click enter. Enter purchase group. And click enter. Enter value price 20. Once we enter the value price, click save. Here we can see the purchase requisition number. So until now, we have seen how to create the materials, what are the main changes that are made in the SAP S/4HANA after the migration to sourcing and procurement, and how we can create the purchase requisition. What are the capabilities of sourcing and procurement? So, continuation of this topic, we'll see how to convert the purchase requisition to purchase order and how to create purchase order. Okay, so now we are going to see requirements and requirement processing and purchase order processing. So let us see requirement processing and purchase order processing. The current processing is a unique value of SAP S/4HANA. Usually in SAP RP3 or in SAP ERP, purchase requisition are transferred into a purchase order. During the transaction, the SAP S/4HANA sourcing and procurement, used to convert purchase requisitions. Purchase requisitions into purchase orders. In SAP Fiori apps, in the SAP GUI, the system processes for specific items. After a source of supply assigned, the purchase requisition can be transferred into a purchase order. In this we have flexible search, and across the entire list of open purchase requisition where there is no time consuming, we can group filters and download purchase requisitions from the customer point of view. We have been fixed like fast and efficient handling of purchase requisition and we have an option of automatic and manual purchase process and purchase order error rate will be reduced by creating and integrating. When you compare with the core ERP, no changes are done in the data model. And simplification list is only available at new SAP Fiori apps. So in the purchase requisition, in purchase order processing, in this process, we create purchase orders. While creating the purchase order manually, purchases face high system support. Previously, to create purchase orders, ME21N, transaction code. Now, in SAP S/4HANA, to speed up the process, creating manually, no Fiori apps were developed. Create and manage budget orders. By this, the Fiori apps, the errors are minimized for the change process because it contains restricted set of available field entries. With purchase order processing, customer can create display change and process purchase orders in one integrated system. And they have both manual as well as automatic functions. So we can create purchase orders in three different ways. Purchase orders with reference to purchase requisitions. Purchase order with reference to purchase order with reference to RFQ and without reference. So in this tree we can create purchase orders, purchase requisitions is a procedure method may request for the purchase of goods and service. It requires processing by using the procurement services, and it is a request that is made for purchasing the organization certain list of materials. And it remains within the organization. Purchase requisitions gets approval from purchasing organizations. If purchase requisition is approved, the changes are possible only to a limited extent. And the RFQ. RFQ is nothing but request for quotation. Request for quotation is a standard business process whose purpose is to invite a supplier to bid on specific product or services. Using operational procurement, the one-stop purchase order processing with SAP S/4HANA. The purchaser is supported with the variety of capabilities to speed up the processing of manually created purchase orders. Procurement and we created for various types of goods and services for creating purchase orders. So these are the formal documents that are given to vendor, and it includes list of goods and materials. That has to be procured. The purchase order can be created for different types of procurement. Based on procurement, there are different types of purchase orders, such as subcontracting, purchase order, consignment purchase order, and service purchase orders. So these are the different types of purchase orders based on procurement. So let us see this in the screen on the SAP logon. Double click on S4 ideas. Enter the user best password W_Welcome123. Let's continue this logon. Let us enter ME21. And click enter. So here we can see different types of purchase order: standard, consignment, stock transfer. Now, let's create the purchase order. Copy the Fury link. Let's copy the Fury link. So let us double click on Google Chrome. So let us paste the link and click enter. Enter the user's best password W_Welcome123 and click enter. And here click on search icon. So enter create purchase order app. So let us click enter. double-click on this and select render in SAP ERP. The custom master data and rental master data must be maintained separately. This means that if a purchase master data acts as a business partner acts as a customer, as a vendor in other processes, master data for these business processes the target approach in the SAP S/4HANA is the business partner approach. By using this approach, it is possible to centrally manage master data for customers, and vendors. In SAP S/4HANA, business partner maintaining with the transaction or using a corresponding app and maintaining the business partner. There is no specific user interface for customer. As it is present in the SAP ERP. XP01, XP02, PV01, PV02, XP01. These are not available. These transactions are not available yet. So these are mainly available in ERP and the SAP S/4HANA. So this one is on the SAP S/4HANA GUI. In SAP Fiori, for this we are using the app. Maintaining the business partner. A BP transaction is a single point of entry to create, edit, and to maintain for business partner. Now let us see this. Let us continue with GUI window. Enter the XT01 transaction code in the S/4HANA. Then it will show you it is directly redirected it is redirected to BP instead of XP01. This T code is no more existing in SAP S/4HANA. This T code is replaced with BP transaction code. So let us double click on ECC. Let us enter. So let's provide the password. Welcome 123. Enter the transaction FP01. So here we can see by seeing the transaction SP. So this T code is not available SAP S/4HANA. Now in Fury, so here we can see maintain business partners. Create customer and vendor. Now to create the vendor, we're using the T code XK01. In Fury, we use maintain business partners. When we create the business partner, we have to select a business partner category based on the business partner roles. A certain set of things have to be fulfilled with data. Now let us go back to the purchase order screen to check the vendor, select the vendor, click on find. Select the vendor. And let us click on organization data. Select purchase organization. Select purchasing groups. Enter the company code 1010. Enter the materials. So this is the material we created previously. Enter the plant 1010. So let's enter the storage location. Now, so once we enter all these details, now let us click on save. Now here we can see purchase order is created. So purchase order is created without reference. So in this purchase order we created. Now, let us create purchase order with reference to purchase requisition. So let us go back. Sí, que antes lo último día. So let us enter the company code. So once we enter the company code 1010, all the vendors that are related to company code 1010, click on organization data, select purchase organization 1010, select the purchasing group, double 01, and the company code 1010. So here we need to enter the purchase acquisition number to create the purchase order with reference to purchase acquisition. Enter 1000 1514. This is the purchase acquisition that is created. And click enter. Well, let us enter the quantity 20. And click on save. Now here we can see purchase order is created. Reference to the purchase position. So up till now, until now we have seen creating a purchase order with and without reference, and third one is with reference to RFQ. As we created with reference to purchase acquisition, we need to enter the RFQ, the purchase order. While creating the purchase order with respect to the RFQ.
The rest I will continue in the next session. Thank you all the participants. Thank you.